it's Janie. Welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I thought I would introduce you to two of my sugar gliders. These are two little guys that I adopted from a lady that was needing to get rid of them that lived in Broken Arrow. These are not the two babies that I purchased back in October. These I just purchased in November. We are still in the bonding process, but these guys are a lot more socialized than the two little ones that I have, so they are a little bit easier to work with. When I get into, I'll put them into the bonding tent, which is just a little mesh tent that I have set up in my living room. It has toys, and it has an exercise wheel in it. That is specifically for sugar gliders, and I will let them romp around and play, and then I will get in to the tent with them. And as soon as I get in, they jump right on me, and they like to get back in underneath my shirt in the back and go to sleep back there, and they don't hardly want to get out of there. There's a male and a female in here, and the male has been neutered. So there is not going to be any type of reproduction going on. Thank goodness. I don't want any baby sugar gliders. And the male's name is Olaf. And when you see him, if I can show them in the pouch. I'm still not able to just sit and hold them. If I grab hold of them, the first thing they want to do is get away from me and get in behind and get on my shirt back there. And then the female, her name is Peaches. And she is a white face blonde. From the best that I can tell, they did not come with any kind of paperwork that showed exactly what they are. I mean, there's no lineage on them. The only thing the lady really did know about them was that they were over a year old. Their original owner that had them from the time that they were out of the pouch up until probably a year and a half ago. Well, that would make them over a year ago, a year old. I don't know how long he had them, but he was a young man in his early 20s, and he died. And his family did not want to deal with the sugar gliders because they are a lot of work. And so they went to a lady that was in the military. And after she had them for a while, she decided that she did not have the time to devote to them because they do take a lot of time, they take a lot of work, and there's a lot to them. And so she sold them to the lady that I got them from. She had them for about 6 months, so they may be going on 2 years old. I really don't know. And I know that she had them for about 6 months, and the reason why she wanted to get rid of them was that she had just gotten a new puppy and didn't have time for them. And I think a lot of times why they get moved around to so many different hands is that people just don't realize how much work they are as far as keeping their cage clean. These guys came with a huge cage. I mean, it's almost as tall as I am. It's probably like 5 feet tall. I'm 5'4", and it comes to about here on me. And it's a huge cage, and it's a daily task on keeping it clean, especially with Olaf being a male. He does like to mark, even though he has been fixed. He still likes to mark. She will even mark. So she's looking at me like, "Are you talking about me?" So that makes, you know, there is some odor. I'm trying to introduce them slowly to the other two. The other two are a male and a female, and they are 6 months and younger. And so what I've been doing is I have their cages next to each other, and I've been switching their little sleeping pouches. So these guys will sleep in this one for a couple days, and then I'll take it out and put it in with Chase and Pepper, and I'll take Chase and Pepper's sleeping pouch and put in with Olaf and Peaches to try and get them used to each other's smell. We did decide one night to put them into the bonding tent together. That kind of went okay, but unfortunately my littlest one, and I was very surprised because I figured that Chase, my other male, who's been neutered also, and Olaf would probably fight, being the two males. I mean, I just figured that. And my little female, Pepper, who is, out of all four of them, she's the meanest. She's the one that has bit me time and time again and has drew blood every single time. But she just wanted to fight everybody. She even started wanting to fight Chase, who's her cage mate, who I have not known to, you know, fighting. But anyway, I'm going to try and take out some of the little blankets here and see if we can get them to show you, if you're going to be able to see in here. I hope you can. I did this video once, and I had no sound, and it was turned out so good because you were able to see them so good. They peeked out, and but there was no sound to it, so you can see them shuffling around. Of course, if you can tell there, Olaf, there's Olaf. He is the white one. He is a mosaic. He has white with a little bit of gray throughout him, and then Peaches, if I did not say that, is a white face blonde, meaning that she does not have the black markings up underneath her face like the standard grays have. Oh, look, there's Olaf peeking out. He's so pretty. Now he will bite, and there's Peaches. He will definitely bite, but he is the one that, if I have the cage door open when I'm trying to feed him, and if he's out of his pouch, he makes a beeline for me and wants to get out and jump on me and run around and try and see what's going on in the world. But I'm not going to reach my hand down in there because we are still in the bonding process, and I'm not going to invade their space. They're shuffling around quite a bit, but there is Olaf, and they're pretty good size compared to the other two. And I'm going to try and bring the other two in here and see if you can see them. Hi, Olaf. I don't have a treat for you. No. I usually have a treat. And their favorite thing to eat, they really like to have avocado. And they like to have carrots, and they like celery. Oh, there he is. They are not so keen on their apples or their pears, or they haven't really liked any fruit that I have put in for them to have at night, do you? See, he has the black eyes. Like I said, he's got, you know, a little bit of gray. I can't really tell if he's mosaic or if he might be piebald. I'm pretty sure he's mosaic. And her, she's really sweet. Yeah, are y'all nervous or nervous? So anyway, these are the two sugar gliders that I have that are the older two. They just want to be left alone. It's kind of early too. They are nocturnal. They sleep during the day and get up at night. And this is still their sleeping time, isn't it? Yeah. You want y'all's blankets back? They're looking for their little blankets too. They're cold. So we'll put those back in there. And I'm going to go get the other two and see if we can get them to behaved where you can see them a little bit. Okay, I am back, and now I have, I don't know if you hear that, I have Pepper and Chase, And the noise, if you heard that, is called crabbing, and that's what they do in the wild for protection, trying to scare their prey away. They will also try and put their little paws up like this and stand up on their hind legs and try and make themselves look as big as they can and do that little crabbing noise. And that's because they are not completely socially bonded. We have been working on it. I got these little guys in October, and I will admit I did purchase them at the fair, the Tulsa State Fair, and unknowingly at the time, and I did purchase them pretty much from a Sugar Glider mill. So they had a cage, you know, that had a whole bunch of little sugar gliders in them. I did not pick. The lady just reached in, and whatever she was able to get a hold of is what I got. The only specific that I was able to do was that I wanted a male and a female. So that's what I have. Chase is the bigger of the two, and then Pepper is the smaller, and she is the girl. Chase has been fixed, so there will not be any baby sugar gliders. Did not want to get into that at all. And I kind of regret purchasing these two from the fair, but then on the other hand, I'm glad that I did, because, you know, this is, in the way I look at it, this was two little sugar gliders that was saved from the mill. Anyway, so they are requiring a little bit more work than the other two, for sure. They definitely are needing some work, and these two are standard grays. They're just your normal standard sugar gliders that you see. There's nothing special. And this one that is poking out, I'll do this so that you can see. It's very hard for me to tell them apart, to be honest with you, because they look very almost identical. Pepper, the girl, has a little bit more white around her ears than Chase does. And Chase is a little bit more inquisitive. He's definitely nosy. He likes to check things out. So this one, they may not be going to show like the other two did. Probably not. Which I didn't think they would, but take one of their little blankets out. Have their little snuggy blankets. Just little pieces of, you want to call it felt, but it's not felt, it's fleece. That's what it is. And this little pouch here, I did purchase off of Etsy, and it came with a whole bunch of other stuff. It's called a cage kit, I think, or something. It had a whole bunch of different stuff in it, but there is Chase and Pepper, and they're gonna stay hid. And like I said, these two guys, I definitely cannot reach in there and take out and grab, or I would get, eight up. Usually how I handle these two little guys, if I have to catch them, is I have a bigger piece of fleece that's about four times the size, and I just take this in my hand and put over them and wrap them up into that and pull them out that way. Now, when we're in the bonding tent together, they will get on me and they will let me pet them, and they will get in between my legs, and if they're wanting some place to go to hide and to go back to sleep, they'll get in between my legs. They will take treats from me. They like to eat honey, and they will lick honey off my finger. But as far as being able to pick them up and hold them, no. Chase doesn't do too much with trying to bite. He will hiss at me. But Pepper, she wants to, she will bite as hard as she can and hard, won't you, girl? Yeah. And she will. There is one of them's little face. sugar gliders, and I try to get them. I get them out every night and bond with them. Part of the bonding process is putting them in a bonding pouch. It's pretty much something similar to this, except it has a zipper on it where they can't get out. And I tuck them down into my shirt and wear them around. It has a little string around it. Or I'll get into the bonding tent with them and let them play and just let them jump all over me. The reason why I'm doing this is part of the bonding, is just kind of pressing them against you where they can hear your voice and your smell. And plus, they kind of like when you're pressing like this, it makes them feel a little bit more secure. I mean, I'm not doing that hard. I'm not hurting them. They would definitely let me know if I was hurting them. But yeah, wouldn't you? As soon as I open it, they go back in there. So, anyway. One of them is letting me pet them. I'm pretty sure this is Chase. There we go. As long as I'm not trying to grab them out, they're probably okay. But we're going to do round two in the bonding tent with these two guys and the two older ones. As soon as my husband gets done with his paperwork, because he has to be there with me, so if we have to hurry up and separate them, then there's two of us in there that can do that. We keep big pieces of fleece, like I said, so that we can grab hold of them gently if we need to and get them separated. The last time I had all four in the bonding tent, the two older ones, Olaf and Peaches, as soon as I opened the tent door, they were out of there. They were jumped on me and in my shirt. They were done with the other two. They were done. So, and then these two guys, they were just super happy that they were gone and that they had the tent back to themselves like they're used to. But anyway, so that is my sugar gliders. I hope that you have enjoyed, and I will talk to you soon.